Let us prove this theorem. If two secants intersect outside the circle, then the measure of the angle form is equal to 1/2 the positive difference between the measures of the intercepted arcs. Let us draw a circle with center O. Then let us draw a secant and then another secant intersecting outside the circle. Let us name this secant AC and the second secant BD. They intersect outside the circle at point E. So our given secants AC and BD intersect at point E outside circle O. We are going to prove that the measure of angle AEB, this angle, is equal to 1/2 times the measure of arc AB minus the measure of arc CD. We are going to prove the theorem using a two-column proof. On the first column, we are going to write the statements, and on the second column, the corresponding reasons. For our first statement, we have the given. Secants AC and BD intersect at point E outside circle O. The reason is given. And then for our second statement, we are going to draw line BC. There are 2 points here, B and C. 2 points determine a straight line. So the reason is line postulate. This is our illustration. For our statement number 3, we have the measure of angle ACB is equal to 1/2 the measure of arc AB. This angle ACB is equal to 1/2 the measure of arc AB. And the measure of angle DBC is equal to 1/2 the measure of arc CD. This angle DBC, this one, is equal to 1/2 the measure of arc CD. And the reason is the measure of an inscribed angle is equal to 1/2 the measure of its intercepted arc. For the next statement, we have the measure of angle ACB, this one, angle ACB. This angle ACB is an exterior angle with respect to triangle CBE. And angle AEB, this angle, and angle DBC are remote interior angles with respect to the exterior angle ACB. And this measure of angle ACB is equal to the measure of angle AEB plus the measure of angle DBC. And this is according to this reason. The reason is the measure of an exterior angle is equal to the sum of its remote interior angles. Now, this is the left side of the equation, and this is the right side. If the left side is equal to the right side of the equation, then the right side is equal to the left side. Therefore, this can be written as the measure of angle AEB plus the measure of angle DBC is equal to the measure of angle ACB. In algebra, we learn that if A is equal to B, then B is equal to A. And the reason is symmetric property of equality. For statement number 6, we are going to subtract the measure of angle DBC from the left side of this statement, and we are going to subtract it also from the right side of this statement, and the result is statement number 6. This is our illustration. For our statement number 6, we have the measure of angle AEB is equal to the measure of angle ACB minus the measure of angle DBC. The reason is subtraction property. In statement number 3, we said that the measure of angle ACB is equal to 1 half the measure of arc AB. And the measure of angle DBC is equal to 1 half the measure of arc CD. So for our statement number 7, the measure of angle AEB is equal to, we are going to substitute 1 half the measure of arc AB for the measure of angle ACB, and 1 half the measure of arc CD for the measure of angle DBC. Let us do that. So this is now equal to 1 half the times the measure of arc AB minus 1 half times the measure of arc CD. The reason is substitution. On the right side of this equation, we can see that there is a common factor. The common factor is the 1 over 2 or 1 half. We are going to factor this out. So for our last statement, we have the measure of angle AEB is equal to 1 half times the quantity measure of arc AB minus measure of arc CD. The reason is factoring.